Hey, all 8th graders, it's Colette, your typical host for Saturdays, but I have a very good reason why I'm making my video this evening on a Sunday. My bathroom went out of commission last Sunday, and I only have one bathroom in my house, and what happened was the toilet was leaking, and we came upon this discovery Sunday night, and then Monday, pulling back the flooring, we saw that the floor was soaked. And once we removed that, we noticed the subfloor was rotted. And then when we finally got the thick subfloor cut out, the joists were rotted. So we were able to get like a contractor out here who assessed the situation, helped us finish up the job, and then installed a brand new floor. So now my bathroom looks spiffy. And yesterday we spent part of the day cleaning things up and sealing grout, and then we put the toilet in. So now I actually have a functioning toilet. So, and once the grout's done sealing, we're going to put our vanity in. Yay! I have a bathroom again. So, yesterday I didn't have a chance to make a video, and today was shaping up to be the same way, but I'm like, I have time. I'm going to do it now because we're going on break, people, 2 weeks off. So, yeah. Anyway, this week's topic comes from Jason. And his topic is, people have a hard time getting to know one another and also paying people and even oneself a compliment. My challenge to you collaborators, mention 2 things that people may not know about you. Also say 1 positive thing about each of the collaborators. And lastly, say 1 positive thing about yourself. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and pay compliments to everyone because that's my favorite thing. I'll start with Michelle, who is amazing, and I'm loving getting to know her on this channel. I've watched her personal channel and Outlet for Great for a number of years, and she just has this really warm, engaging vibe about her, and when I see her, I always just see like a positive light around her, so she's just a really awesome person, and I love that she's a big animal lover. Miss Maya in Australia. When I first started the channel, on Outlet for Great, I loved getting to know that she's a big animal freak as well, and she takes care of all these different critters, and she just seems like such a cool person. Like, if I went to Australia, I would definitely want to chill out with her. She's just kind of got this calm, cool demeanor, which I think is engaging. Jim in Atlanta is sassy. I love Jim in Atlanta. I would love to go down the south and hang out with him, and I'd love to see some of his artwork. He seems like just a really, really great person, and who else? Jim in Ohio has an amazing backyard that's green and lush, and he has this really awesome, jovial personality. And I kind of wish like all of these hosts live near me so we could like hang out and stuff, but he seems to have like another really like cool vibe to him. I'd love to get to know him and his future hubby better. And another all the hosts on here are really awesome. And lastly, Jason in Hawaii. Jason's kind of got this like endearing, kind of like childlike vibe about him. Like, in a sense that, like, I follow him on Facebook and stuff. It's, like, he really cares a lot about the world and his place in it. And it's one of those, like, qualities I look for in people, like, when making friends with people. And he kind of has, like, this kind of open heart to the world. And that's what I mean by, like, the childlike. Because I feel like children always have, like, this open heart, which is something that I feel like as adults we end up trying to, like, attain again because we lose it. But he kind of seems to have that quality about him. So once again, another person that has a really warm personality. And myself, a positive thing about myself, I have to say that I'm really proud of the fact that even if I'm scared of a situation, I always push myself through it. So I guess you could say bravery, but I prefer to say adventurous. Even if I'm really nervous and anxious, I seem to just unconsciously put myself in uncomfortable situations to learn and just to experience. So that's something I would say would be positive about me. And two things that people may not know about me well. I used to be a ballet dancer, and I did that for a number of years in high school and in my 20s. And I would dance about 9 hours a day. I absolutely loved that side of my life. That was prior to transition and everything. And that was, I loved rehearsal. I loved the aspect of practice. That's something that has given me a lot of discipline. I need to tap back into that because I've become quite undisciplined in my life. And another side of that was I used to perform a lot in coffee shops. I wrote a lot of my own songs on guitar, and I also sang covers, and I did that for a little while. I haven't written in a long time. That's something that, as I was transitioning, I realized it was something I needed to do, and I had forgotten about it, distracting myself with trying to survive in the world. And another thing is I used to be a painter and an artist. I used to do a lot of watercolor and acrylic paintings, and I still have all the supplies and the canvases, but that's another thing that has fallen, I think, to the wayside in my life. But that's something that, once again, coming to terms with who I am and accepting myself, it's something that I'm now going back to, which is awesome. So I kind of feel like my soul's being nourished again, I guess you could say. So yeah, that's a couple things about me that you may not know. And I hope you guys have a wonderful summer break, and we'll be back in 2 weeks. And yeah, take care and be safe. Bye.